Good afternoon, Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Indian Council of World Affairs. It is our pleasure to have with us His Excellency, Mr. Ivica Dacic, First Deputy Prime Minister and Minister of Foreign Affairs of the Republic of Serbia. Mr. Dacic will be delivering the 29th Sapru House Lecture on Serbia in the region, Europe, and the world. May I now request DG ICWA to greet our esteemed guests with a bouquet of flowers. Thank you. Let me now brief you about today's program. The lecture will be chaired by Ambassador Nalin Suri, Director General, Indian Council of World Affairs. First, DG ICWA would deliver his welcome remarks. Then after, His Excellency Mr. Dacic will deliver the 29th Sapru House Lecture. We will have a brief question and answer session after the lecture. I request that you kindly turn off your cell phones during the session. May I request DG ICWA to proceed to conduct the proceedings?
Thank you, Your Excellency. Your Excellency, distinguished guests, we're running a little bit late, so I'm not going to. We're running a bit late, so I'm not going to spend too much time.
Switch on.
I said we're running a bit late.
No, it's on.
I think we're running a bit late, so I'll be a bit louder. The subject of
today's Sapru House lecture is extremely important, and we couldn't have a better speaker than His Excellency, the First Deputy Prime Minister and Foreign Minister of Serbia. So without much further ado, sir, you have the floor. I believe you will speak in English and take questions and respond in maybe Serbia. Serbokrotin, and your interpreter will reply. Okay, you have the floor, sir.
Thank you very much. Esteemed Ambassador Suri, Excellencies, dear guests, ladies and gentlemen. I'm honored and gratified for this opportunity to address this distinguished meeting and express great pleasure for being in your beautiful country today in a year in which we mark the 70th anniversary of the establishment of the diplomatic relations between our two countries. By a realistic assessment of the security and political challenges we face today, respecting international law, the Republic of Serbia has set the following key foreign policy priorities. Principled struggle for the preservation of its territorial integrity and sovereignty, continuation of the EU negotiation process for full membership, promotion of relations not only with the most influential world powers, strictly adhering to the policy of military neutrality, but also with traditionally friendly countries of Asia, Africa, and Latin America. The government of Serbia is very active in the field of strengthening regional cooperation and connectivity with all partners in the region. We see regional initiatives in which Serbia participates actively as a good way to achieve these goals. We are in favor of creating a single Western Balkans market as a very good way to facilitate foreign investments and boost economic development of the entire region. In addition, aware of the fact that the development is the most important precondition for progress and better future for all of us, we ourselves also invest a lot in the region. We invest in the creativity of young people and the digitalization, the issue of importance not only to Serbia, but also to the most developed countries of the world, including India. Serbia also made its contribution to international peace and security during its last year's presidency of the OSCE Forum for Security Cooperation. We are firmly committed to development of our relation with Russia. The landmark 180th anniversary of the establishment of diplomatic relations between Serbia and the Russian Federation has been marked this year and commemorated by a visit of Foreign Minister Lavrov to Belgrade. Also, progress has been made in our relation with the USA. President Vučić visited Washington, D.C. and invited President Trump to pay a visit to Serbia. The relations with Germany and France are extremely good. As part of celebrating our alliance in the First World War, we expect that President Macron will visit Serbia. Our relations with China are on the ascendant, coupled with a comprehensive strategic partnership by Serbia's active participation in the initiative of President Xi Jinping, Road and Belt, as well as within mechanisms involving China and 16 Central and East European countries. Shinzo Abe was the first Japanese Prime Minister to visit Serbia in 35 years. We would like to join the Association of Southeast Asian Nations and ASEM. We initiated a procedure to acquire an observer status in the Pacific Alliance. We have also undertaken to become an associate member in the International Francophone Organization, in which Serbia has been an observer since 2006, whose membership includes many Asian countries. Procedures are underway to establish diplomatic relations with several Pacific countries: Tuvalu, Nauru, Samoa, Vanuatu, Kiribati, Marshall Islands, Micronesia, Palau, and East Timor. Serbia symbolically demonstrated its commitment to strengthening its relation with Africa by proclaiming the 25th of May, Tito's birthday, as Africa Day, in honor of friendship with African nations, which will be observed every year. We are devoted not only to strengthening bilateral relations with African countries, but also to cooperating with the African Union. We closely follow the situation in the Middle East, building the relations of partnership with all countries in the region, not aligning with any side in the ongoing conflicts and disputes that burden this region. We are also stepping up our bilateral relations with the Latin American countries. We support the initiatives for conflict prevention and peace mediation in resolving disputes within the United Nations and regional organizations. Furthermore, Serbia makes its concrete contribution to the preservation of international peace and security through its active participation in United Nations and European Union peace operations, especially in Africa and the Middle East. We also take an active part in joint efforts of international community aimed at preventing present security challenges, terrorism, cyber and energy security, proving to be a responsible partner in the international community. Of particular importance of our participation in the fight against terrorism and the coalition fighting Daesh. At the same time, we have demonstrated a high level of solidarity with refugees, recognizing the significance of the fight to eradicate poverty and social inequality in preventing the emergency of extremism. Serbia is truly committed to fostering friendly relations and developing various forms of bilateral cooperation with our traditional friends all over the globe, partners from the NAM, recalling the times of the movement's founding fathers, Josip Broz Tito and Jawaharlal Nehru. In that connection, I would like to recall that the Republic of Serbia had the honor to host a meeting in observance of the 50th anniversary of the first conference of the NAM in September 2011 in Belgrade. It provided yet another opportunity to reaffirm traditional friendship
linking Serbia with the movement's member states, as well as our commitment to develop further cooperation in the fields of mutual interest, especially in economic, military, and cultural educational spheres. It is not in collision with Serbia's aspiration to join EU, but represents a complementary dimension of our foreign policy engagement. Our friendships in the East and West are our asset and our strength. Reaching a political solution to the issue of Kosovo and Metohija is our national priority. Serbia is devoted to dialogue between Belgrade and Pristina and fulfillment of its obligations. However, the steps taken by Pristina undermine dialogue and regional stability, bringing into question the security of Serbs and other non-Albanian populations in Kosovo and Metohija. Even though 5 years have passed since the signing of the Brussels Agreement, Pristina failed to fulfill the obligations and had undertaken primarily the establishment of the community of Serb municipalities, which represent a key element of the agreement for the Serbs in Kosovo and Metohija. Resolving the issues of property, cultural and church heritage, cadastral issues, freedom of movement, are also of importance to us. I would like to point out again that Serbia is strongly opposed to the creation of the army on Kosovo, which could jeopardize not only the security in the region and the Belgrade-Pristina dialogue, but also the security of the entire region. I take this opportunity to express deep gratitude to India and all other states which remaining committed to the principles of rule of law in international framework, have not recognized unilaterally declared independence of Kosovo. That act was contrary to the UN Charter, the Helsinki Final Act, and UN Security Council Resolution 1245 which guarantees territorial integrity of the Republic of Serbia. At the same time, I call upon all states that had recognized the unilaterally declared independence of Kosovo to re-examine that decision, thus encouraging both sides to seek a mutual acceptable solution through dialogue. Even though geographically far apart from India, the Republic of Serbia has a long tradition of close and friendly relations with the Republic of India, which has always been a reliable partner of my country. In a year commemorating the 70th anniversary since the establishment of diplomatic relations between India and Yugoslavia at that time, whose integral part Serbia was and later a successor state, I note with great pleasure that there were many ties even before the establishment of this relation. A great Indian thinker, Rabindranath Tagore, a Nobel Prize winner for literature, visited Belgrade almost 100 years ago, in November 1926. In the famous Kolarac Music Hall, where the entire Belgrade gathered, Tagore was reciting his poetry in Bengali to residents of Belgrade. As Daily Politica reported then, he seemed closed, familiar and understandable to all listeners who had a chance to listen to him for the first time. Even today, we read with joy and pride the words of this famous Indian thinker who told his collocutor, Bishop Nikolai Milimirovic, that in Serbia he felt as a bird who has two nests on two opposing coasts. Ramayana and Mahabharata are still part of curricula in our schools, while Bollywood films and TV series, some even filmed in Serbia, enjoy huge popularity. The interest in traditional and modern Indian culture, literature, dance, cuisine is constantly rising. Traditional and modern Indian medicine, Ayurveda, yoga, and pharmaceutical products are present and popular in Serbia. I am convinced that the decision of the government of the Republic of Serbia to abolish visas for holders of regular Indian passports to enter, transit, and stay in the Republic of Serbia for up to 30 days within the year, taken on 2nd September 2017, will facilitate the flow of people and ideas and thus open up avenues for the promotion of cooperation. Serbia follows with great attention and appreciation and impressive growth of Indian economy and its positioning among the most successful economies in Asia and the world. We can learn a lot from Indian development programs, Digital India, Make in India, Startup India, Smart Cities, Skill India, and we can even participate in some of them. Last year's visit of Aleksandar Vučić to India, Prime Minister and at that time and currently President of Serbia, who's participated on the vibrant Gujarat summit, greatly promoted bilateral cooperation. In the discussions with the highest ranking Indian officials, headed by Prime Minister Narendra Modi, it was mutually noted that there were many potential opportunities to expand cooperation in the field of agriculture, food and industry, car and tractor manufacturing, IT, military industry, healthcare, pharmaceuticals, films, sport, tourism, etc. Cooperation with Indian companies is of importance to us. Investments of the embassy group from Bangalore in IT Park in Serbia, TAFE, which purchased the EMT tractors, Indian companies Mahindra and Sonalike with tractor assembly facilities in Serbia, and many others. On the other hand, Serbian company Schneider Electric DMNS participates in the project of the Indian government construction of smart city Naya Raipur. I genuinely believe that these positive examples of cooperation will encourage other investors and companies to come to our country. It should be said that the economy of the Republic of Serbia offers many benefits to foreign investors. Among other things, by way of free trade agreements we have with Russia, Ukraine, Belarus, Azerbaijan, Kazakhstan, and Turkey, offering them benefits in access to third market. That is why I would like to take this opportunity to invite Indian business people to visit Serbia and see for themselves great possibilities and potentials it offers. For our part, we shall continue to encourage Serbian business people to promote cooperation with India by providing information on vast possibilities offered by Indian market and its economy. It is in mutual interest to develop further economic cooperation between our countries. I would like to conclude this statement by the wise words of Rabindranath Tagore. Civilization must be judged and prized not by the amount of power it has developed, but by how much it has evolved and given expression to, by its laws and institutions, the love of humanity. Let us therefore stay together on the road to peace, equality, justice, and prosperity for all. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Excellency. May I, in my capacity as chair, start the ball rolling by asking you about the likelihood of Serbia's membership of the European Union and why you attach so much importance to this membership?
Pa znate šta, evo da
Srbija geografski pripada Evropi.
Geographically speaking, Serbia belongs in Europe.
Svuda oko nas je Evropska unija.
We are practically surrounded by the European Union.
To otvara mogućnost Srbiji pre svega za ekonomski razvoj.
It opens up the possibilities primarily to Serbia for its economic development.
Ali i za reformu različitih oblika društva, različitih sektora društva.
But also for to reforms of different sectors of society.
I to u suštini treba da ima pozitivan efekat na razvoj društva.
And it essentially should have a positive effect on the development of our society.
Ali kao I svuda u međunarodnim odnosima,
but as elsewhere in the international relations,
uvek postoje primjeri određenih duplih standarda.
There are always some examples of double standards being applied.
I određenih političkih uslovljavanja koje stvaraju teškoće.
And certain political conditionalities that actually create difficulties.
Tako da kao što sam rekao, Srbija želi da bude član Europske unije.
So like I said, Serbia would like to become a member of the European Union.
Ali ne na štetu naših nacionalnih interesa.
But not to the detriment of its national interests.
I ne na štetu naših dobrih odnosa sa našim tradicionalnim prijateljima.
And not to the detriment of our good relations that we have with our traditionally friendly countries.
Ja želim samo da da dodam da
let me add.
Ja od kad znam za sebe, znači za mene su Indija, Jugoslavija I Egipat osnivači pokreta nesvrstanih.
And just let me add that ever since I was a small child, ever I know for myself, India, Yugoslavia, Egypt, I have been a traditional friend as part of the non-aligned movement.
To su poznata slika Tito, Nehru, Nasser.
There is this famous photo of Tito, Nehru and Nasser.
U Beogradu I danas postoje ulice Gandijeva, Nehruova.
And in Belgrade, even today, we have streets named after Gandhi, Nehru.
Ja sam se juče sreo, sinoć sam se sreo sa unukom Mahatma Gandija, Tarom Gandhi.
Last night I had a meeting with the granddaughter of Mahatma Gandhi, Tara Gandhi.
To je u Srbiji danas vest dana.
And in Serbia it is the breaking news, the news of the day.
Hoću da kažem koliko poštovanje I dalje imaju naši tradicionalni prijatelji.
That just goes on to say how much respect our traditional friends still enjoy in my country.
Međutim, kada je Tito umro,
however, when Tito died,
došlo je do raspada Jugoslavije.
Yugoslavia broke up.
Taj raspad je potpomognut nekim, od strane nekih zapadnih zemalja.
That breakup has been supported by some western countries.
Zato što velika Jugoslavija, tako velika I uticajna, nije odgovarala.
Because such a big country as Yugoslavia was, it was not in line with the interests that they had.
Jugoslavia je bila jedina zemlja u Evropi koja je bila nesvrstana.
Yugoslavia was the only country in Europe that belonged to the non-aligned movement.
Osim Kipra u to vreme.
In addition to Cyprus at that time.
Tako da potpomognuti nacionalizmom.
So supported by nationalist forces.
Jugoslavija se raspala na te svoje bivše federalne jedinice.
Yugoslavia broke up into its former federal units.
Međutim, I tako ono što je ostalo od Srbije.
And what remained of Serbia?
I to je bilo za neke zapadne zemlje mnogo.
For some western countries it seemed to be too much or too big.
Tako da su onda potpomogli da se jedna provincija u Srbiji ocepi.
And they actually came in support of a province that seceded from
to je Kosovo.
And I'm speaking of Kosovo here.
Mislim da samo razumete situaciju.
I just wanted to let you to explain to you the situation as it is.
Na Kosovu ne živi narod koji nema svoju državu.
The residents, the people living in Kosovo is not the people that already does not have a state of its own.
Pa da je sada reč o nekom pravu na samoopredeljenje.
In which case we would have been discussing here the right to self-determination.
Na Kosovu žive Albanci I Srbi.
In Kosovo we have Albanians and Serbs living together.
Znači, to je bila albanska nacionalna manjina u Srbiji.
So we are speaking here about the Albanian national minority that lived in Serbia.
Koja je imala svoju matičnu državu Albaniju.
And they already have their own mother state, state of Albania.
To bi bilo da sada da neko, bilo ko u nekim zemljama vašim, autonomno proglasi, jednostrano proglasi nezavisnost.
And that would be the same situation if any part of your respect, respective countries, actually you have a certain part that unilaterally would declare independence from the rest of the state.
Sa vama, sa zemljom od koje se ocepljuje.
Without first entering into some sort of negotiations or agreement.
To se sad, na primjer, dešava u Španiji.
So we have the similar situation taking place in Spain now.
Gde Katalonija kaže da oni idu putem Kosova.
But Catalonia is now claiming that they're following in the footsteps of Kosovo.
E sada, oni koji su priznali Kosovo, sad su oni u problemu.
Those that have recognized Kosovo now are experiencing problems.
Kako da objasne da je moguće za Kosovo, a nije moguće za Kataloniju?
How can they possibly explain that in the case of Kosovo, the declaration of independence is okay, and in the case of Catalonia, it's not?
Tako da, očigledno je, na tom primjeru je prekršeno međunarodno pravo. I to je loš presedan.
It is obvious that we have here the violation of international law and we are dealing here with a very bad precedent.
I obično se kaže, kad neko hoće da opravda nezavisnost Kosova, kaže, to je slučaj za sebe.
And when all those seeking to justify the independence of Kosovo, they always say this is a sui generis case or a very specific case.
A vi dobro znate da engleski pravni sistem
and you're fully aware that the English legal system
počiva na presedanima.
Actually rests upon, it's a precedent law.
Prema tome, nemoguće je da se to primenjuje samo na Kosovo.
Accordingly, it is not possible that this will only be applied to Kosovo alone.
Mi hoćemo dogovor sa Prištinom.
We are in favor of agreement with Priština.
Ali ne možemo da prihvatimo tako jednostrane akte.
But we cannot possibly accept unilateral acts.
Mi smo zbog toga bombardovani.
And therefore we experienced air strikes against us.
I mi to nismo prihvatili.
And we still have not accepted that.
I ja samo želim da vam definišem, da vam objasnim kako to izgleda na svetskoj karti.
And I just would like to explain how the situation looks like at the global level, at the world map.
Amerika, Velika Britanija,
United States, United Kingdom,
su priznale Kosovo,
have recognized Kosovo,
i većina zapadnih zemalja,
and most of the Western countries,
Indija, Rusija,
however, India,
Kina,
Russia, China,
nisu priznale,
have not.
Nije priznala Indonezija.
Indonesia has not. Indonesia
nije
has not recognized.
Nije priznao it. Vjetnam.
Vjetnam.
Filipini.
The Philippines.
Nisu priznale ove okolne zemlje Nepal, Bhutan,
Nepal, Bhutan,
Sri Lanka, Kambodža, Laos.
Cambodia, Laos, Lao People's Republic.
Iran, Irak.
Iran, Iraq.
Nisu priznali. Yes.
They are among those that have not recognized.
Palestina nije priznao.
Palestine also did not recognize.
Nije priznao ni Izrael.
Israel also did not.
Liban nije priznao.
The Lebanon.
Zatim Južnoafrička republika.
The Republic of South Africa.
Mozambik,
Etiopija.
Alžir, Tunis, Maroko.
Algiers, Tunisia,
Nigerija.
Morocco, Nigeria.
Nisu priznale Brazil, Argentina.
Brazil, Argentina.
Meksiko.
Meksiko.
U Evropi, Španija.
In Europe we have Spain.
Grčka, Kipar.
Greece, Cyprus.
Rumunija.
Rumunija.
Slovačka i tako
dalje. Slovak Republic and so on and so forth.
Znači, kada pogledate, ako hoće da budemo... Međutim, šta se dešava?
What is actually taking place here?
Na primjer, prva zemlja koja je priznala Kosovo bila je Kostarika.
The first country to recognize the independence of Kosovo was Costa Rica.
Koja veze nema ni pojma nema da je Kosovo.
Which probably doesn't have a clue where Kosovo is and what the situation there is all about.
Ali neko im je rekao da to urade.
But they were told by someone to do that.
Pa onda Afganistan.
And then second place would be Afghanistan.
Pa onda, ove pacifičke zemlje, sve ove što sam spomenuo, ove male zemlje.
And many Pacific countries that I have referred to earlier on.
Znači, oni ne znaju ništa o tome.
So these are the countries that actually are not aware of the state of affairs.
Bio sam na
Komorskim ostrovima.
We visited the Comoros.
Oni imaju sličan problem, separatizma.
They have a similar problem of their own involving separatism.
Imaju spor sa Francuskom oko ovog ostrova Mayotte.
They have a dispute with France over the island of Mayotte.
A oni su priznali Kosovo.
And they have also recognized Kosovo.
I oni ne mogu da se ove sadašnje vlasti, e sada, posle 10 godina, znači Kosovo nije uspelo da postane član Ujedinjenih nacija i neće nikad ni uspeti.
So after 10 years since the proclamation of independence, Kosovo has not managed to become a member of the United Nations and it never will.
U konkretnoj situaciji nama tu pomaže Rusija.
In this concrete situation, we are, in this respect, we are supported and helped by Russia.
Sa kojim imamo izuzetno dobre odnose i koja će staviti veto na eventualno tako predlog na sednici Saveta bezbednosti.
Russia, with which we have excellent relation and which, as a permanent member of the United Nations Security Council, may exercise and will exercise the power of veto.
E sad se vraćam na vaše pitanje o Evropskoj uniji.
And now let me return to the question that you posed earlier on regarding European Union.
Mi hoćemo da uđemo u Evropsku uniju.
We would like to join the European Union.
A te zemlje su na međunarodnoj sceni na strani Kosova.
But the countries that we would like to join are at international level on the side of Kosovo.
A s druge strane, Evropska unija traži od nas da imamo zajedničku spoljnu politiku sa njima.
And on the other side, the European Union is asking us to pursue common foreign policy with them.
A to znači da uvedemo sankcije prema Rusiji.
Which would imply that we would have to introduce sanctions against Russia.
Da proteramo ruske diplomate sada, pošto Englezi, oko slučaja Skripal i tako dalje.
To expel the Russian diplomats over this incident, the Skripal incident.
A mi ne možemo sada da imamo dobre odnose sa Rusijom i da nam pomažu oko Kosova, a mi da uvedemo sankcije protiv njih.
We cannot possibly have good relations with Russia and ask them to help us just on the account of the European Union.
I hoću da kažem koliko je teška situacija, koliko je sve to teško.
What I'm trying to explain here is just how complex and difficult this situation is.
I kad me neko stalno pita kako, ja stalno kažem, disciplina u kojoj se ja takmičim na olimpijskim igrama.
And when people ask me questions like these, I usually say the discipline that I'm competing in at the Olympics.
Yeah, dribbling na malom prostoru.
It's kind of a, we'll use the soccer term, a dribbling in a small space, a small room.
I zato uživam kad dođem u ovako prijateljske zemlje kao što je Indija.
And that is why I'm extremely gratified when I come on a visit to such friendly countries as India is.
Jer vi ste naši pravi prijatelji.
Because you are our true friends.
I među prijateljima, ja mislim da treba da međusobno se pomažemo i da nađemo zajednički jezik.
And friends and friendship implies that we need to help each other and find common language whenever we can.
Questions?
Yes, please. Master.
Thank you. Mr. Prime Minister, for the detailed explanation. It was very interesting and useful.
Mic me, bolia, please.
I will take back to Kosovo again, which is which I suppose is one of the unsettled problem of the breakup of Yugoslavia. Now you have given the details of the stand and attitude of European countries and other other Western countries. But in particular, I would like to know, in your view, what is the approach and stand of former Yugoslav republics to the problem of Kosovo? Thank you.
So what is Serbia's position and how does it impact the whole issue of immigration in that region? The second question pertains to the non-aligned movement, which is, of course, not as important as it is, but would Serbia in any manner would like to give a new direction so that it can be revitalized and used for the countries who were once a part of the system? Thank you.
Znači, prvo pitanje gospodina bi bilo koji je naš stav prema pitanju imigracije koje je vrlo bilo relevantno u regionu, a drugo bi bilo vezano za pokret nesvrstanih zemalja, da li Srbija ima mogućnost i da li bi mogla da na neki način posluži da se taj pokret revitalizuje, kako, da li postoji neka ideja u tom smislu, da pokret bude relevantniji.
Bivše jugoslovenske republike od osim Bosne i Hercegovine, znači ove druge, Slovenija, Hrvatska, Makedonija i Crna Gora su priznale Kosovo.
As for the question regarding the position of former Yugoslav republics towards the issue of Kosovo, I would like to say that except for Bosnia and Herzegovina, all other former Yugoslav republics recognize the independence of Kosovo, Slovenia, Croatia, Montenegro and Macedonia.
Yes. A to je po principu da susedu crkne krava.
And that is on the principle. We have a saying which I cannot relate to you, but it's not. It boils down to: it's not that I'm going to benefit from it, but my neighbor will be much worse off. So there is a saying to this.
U suštini, znate šta je tu problem? Što te principe koje oni hoće na Kosovu neće u svojim zemljama.
The problem is that the principles that they are trying to apply in Kosovo, these are not the principles that they would like to apply in their own countries.
Znači, kad neko to uradi drugi u svetu, onda to nije prihvatljivo.
When someone else in the world does it, like us, it's not acceptable.
Ali u ovom slučaju je to bilo prihvatljivo.
But in this particular case, it was acceptable.
Jer Srbija je, znači, smanjen je uticaj, znači, to je pritisak na Srbiju.
It boils down actually to the pressures being exerted upon Serbia.
A znate, suština je u tome. Kosovo je bilo mesto gde je nastala Srbija.
But for the essentially, when we speak of Kosovo, for us it is the birthplace of Serbia.
Tamo je bila prvi glavni grad je tamo bio.
This is where we used to have the first capital.
Tamo je sedište crkve.
There used to be a seat of our church.
Tamo je znači, tamo je osnovana prva kraljevina.
The first kingdom has been established there.
Međutim, Srbija se sukobila sa Turskom.
However, at one point in history, Serbia actually came into conflict with Turkey.
I to je poznati u istoriji kosovski boj.
And this was like a historical event, very famous, we feel. The Battle of Kosovo took place.
A bila je battle na Kosovu zato što je tamo bila Srbija.
And the battle of Kosovo actually took place there because it was Serbia that was in Kosovo.
Čak ime Kosovo je srpska reč.
Even the name of Kosovo derives from the Serbian word.
To je znači polje gde živi ta ptica koja se na srpskom kaže kos.
Kos in Serbian is a blackbird, so Kosovo is actually a field where the blackbirds live.
Međutim, za vreme turske okupacije, koja je trajala više od 4 veka,
however, during the Ottoman Turks occupation that lasted more than 4 centuries,
Srbi su proterivani,
Serbs have been expelled from that territory,
a naseljavani su Albanci.
And that territory was populated by the Albanians.
I onda je na kraju, posle nekoliko vekova, Albanci su tu imali većinu.
And several centuries later, the Albanians actually became a majority in that territory.
I oni sada su proglasili svoju državu.
And now they have proclaimed this as their own state.
I sada, objektivno, po rezoluciji Saveta bezbednosti, to je teritorija kojom treba da upravlja misija Ujedinjenih nacija.
Under the UN United Nations Security Council resolution, this is a territory that should be administered by the United Nations.
Ali je tu jednostranu odluku su neke države sa zapada priznale.
However, this unilateral declaration of the independence has been recognized by some Western countries.
A da vam kažem, Kosovo takođe zloupotrebljava to pitanje islama.
On the other hand, Kosovo is actually trying to take advantages, in a way, abuse the issue of Islamic faith.
I to predstavlja kao religiozno pitanje.
because sometimes to some countries they actually wish to present this as a religious matter.
Da su eto Albanci su muslimani, a Srbi su hrišćani, i onda tako teraju islamske zemlje da priznaju Kosovo.
And by stating that they are of Islamic faith and the Serbs are also the Christians, they are actually trying to make some Islamic countries to recognize them.
Tako da mi ovdje imamo u vašem regionu da su Pakistan, Bangladeš,
Afganistan
i Maldivi su priznali.
Maldives recognize the independence of Kosovo.
A slušajte, a to uopšte nije islamski projekat.
And where in effect this is not an Islamic project.
Evo ako pogledate na primjer sada po nekim principijelnim stvarima.
If we have a look you know at some principle matter.
Na primjer Srbija je glasala za Palestinu.
Serbia voted for Palestine.
U međunarodnim forumima.
In international fora.
Albanija i Bosna i Hercegovina ne smije da glasa.
And Albania and Bosnia Hercegovina could not afford to vote.
Jer slušaju neke zemlje sa zapada.
Because they were listening to what some Western countries are telling them to do.
Evo, pošto Izrael nije priznao Kosovo.
Since Israel has not recognized Kosovo.
Onda sad je delegacija Kosova, na primjer, bila u Izraelu.
There was a delegation from Kosovo visiting Israel.
I rekla im je da ako Izrael prizna Kosovo, da će oni da stave ambasadu u Jerusalimu.
And they told their Israeli counterparts that if Israel was to vote in favor of their independence, they're going to establish their, put their embassy in Jerusalem.
Mislim, to je potpuno, premijer Kosova je dao izjavu pre neki dan.
The prime minister of Kosovo just recently made a statement.
Što možda zamislite kako bi to izgledalo da neko tako kaže negde u svetu. Je rekao da Kosovo nema svoju spoljnu politiku.
And you can only imagine what it would be like if someone else gave a statement to that effect, and he actually said that Kosovo did not have its own foreign policy.
Da je njihova spoljna politika politika United States of America.
And that their foreign policy is actually the foreign policy of the United States of America.
I to zvanično se kaže.
And this is what they claim officially and publicly.
Mi mislimo da nesvrstani, da pokret nesvrstanih i dalje ima veliku snagu.
We, on the other issue, your question, we feel that movement on non-aligned countries still are a power to be reckoned with.
Kao i sve u ovom svetu, uvek treba da se nađu neke nove teme.
As all other, as is the case with other things in life, organizations, you need to find the new issues or topics.
Zato što novo je vreme.
Because we live in new times, different times.
Problemi su verovatno možda isti kao pre 50 godina.
Maybe the problems are the same as they used to be some 50 years ago.
Ali treba da se vidi i leadership je isto tako veoma značajno.
I would also add that the problem of leadership is also an issue concerning the movement.
Bio sam na posljednjem sastanku samitu nestanih u Venecueli.
And the latest summit of non-aligned countries in Venezuela.
I, na primjer, oni su stavili slike tako lidera, a nisu stavili Tita, Nehsera i Nehroja.
They actually posted some photos depicting the history of the movement, but they failed to put the photo of Tito, Nasser and Nehru.
Ja sam onda intervenisao, su zaboravili kako je sve počelo.
And I had to intervene and remind them of how it all began way back when.
Tako da je, evo ja sad mogu da uzmem Titov govor iz 70. godine i da ga pročitam i da ne vidite nikakvu razliku u vremenu.
If, for example, I took one of Tito's statements that he made in the 1970s and read it out here, you would probably find it very topical as though nothing has changed.
Osim što nema više jednog bloka.
Except for the fact that one block has disappeared.
Je ostao taj termin detente.
But the term, the wording detente,
a to je
still
popuštanje.
Remained. And this is
I to je neophodno.
And this is what we need.
Henry Kissinger kaže da ne, da on misli da ne može dalje da se zaoštrava situacija.
Henry Kissinger said that the situation can get no worse.
A zašto? Kaže zato što nema gdje dalje.
And it can't get no worse because there's no room for getting any worse than it already
dalje
is. The only thing further on would be war.
Srbija nije imala negativan stav prema migracijama.
On the third question concerning migration, Serbia did not have a negative position toward the migrant.
Nije pravila nikakve zidove, ništa nije proterivala I tako dalje.
It did not erect any walls or expel the refugees.
Europa nema jedinstvenu politiku po mnogo kojim temama, pa između ostalog I po ovoj temi.
Europe does not have a common policy on many issues, including this one.
I to je ono što je loše. Svaka zemlja za sebe određuje politiku.
This is something that is bad because each country is following a policy of its own and defining the policy of its own.
Tako da kad je reč o Srbiji, mi nismo imali ni jedan problem sa migrantima.
So speaking about Serbia, in this respect, we haven't had any problems regarding migrants.
Vi znate da mi još iz vremena Tita kod nas se školovalo na hiljade I desetine hiljada studenata.
You know that ever since the time of Tito, we've had thousands and thousands of people from non-aligned countries getting education in our country.
I za nas je to normalno.
And to us, this is normal.
Mi smo sada ukinuli vize.
We have abolished visas.
Mi smo ukinuli vize za Kinu, za
Indiju, India,
za Rusiju,
Russia,
za Indoneziju,
Indonesia, for
za Iran smo ukinuli.
For Iran as well.
Filipini I tako dalje.
The Philippines and many other countries.
Evropska unija protestuje svaki dan.
The European Union are lodging protests on a daily basis.
A to su naši prijatelji.
And these are our friends.
Mi smo ukinuli vize. I nemamo problem sa migracijom u smislu da neko dolazi da koristi to, pa da ide dalje na zapad.
And we abolished visas to our friends and we don't have a problem in the sense that they would come to us and abuse that facility and travel on somewhere else.
Vi ovde ne biste primetili ni da dođe cela Srbija.
If the entire Serbia came here, you wouldn't have noticed that fact.
We have time for one last question, Dr. Badia.
Sir, my question is also related with the European Union and your Serbia's membership. Since you have already candidate status, country status, but how do you see the emerging trend in European Union, particularly French President Macron called for the reform in the Eurozone and also greater defense cooperation in the among the member EU member states?
Ja to nisam razumela. Nešto je vezano za Evropsku uniju, ali can you just repeat the last time, the last part of the sentence?
Macron's proposals regarding European reform and European defense.
Predlogu vezi sa reformama.
And European defense cooperation.
I saradnja Evropske unije oblasti odbrane.
Pa znači, pa Evropska unija nema oko toga jedinstvenu stav.
The European Union does not a single or common position on that issue.
I ne postoje evropska vojska.
And there is no European army.
Uglavnom se oslanja na NATO.
They are mostly relying on NATO.
Međutim, nisu sve zemlje članice NATO.
However, not all states are members of NATO.
Kao Srbija.
For example, like Serbia.
I u tom smislu mi smo sada u suštini svedoci jedne antiruske histerije koja postoji.
And we are actually now in a situation where there is anti-Russian hysteria.
I gde se, na primer, dešava da je Srbija negde, da na nas gledaju kao da smo mi pro-ruski orijentisani.
And Serbia is looked upon by some others as though we were pro-Russian oriented.
I mislim da to je jedna od tema gde nije Evropska unija mnogo uradila. To je odbrambena saradnja.
And I think this is one of the subjects, the defense policy, that European Union hasn't made a lot of progress.
A drugo da vam kažem, Evropska unija nije isto što I, na primer, Afrička unija ili ne znam ovde, kako kod vas ovde funkcioniše.
European Union is not the same as, for example, African Union.
Tu postoji Evropska unija, postoji prva liga, druga liga, treća liga.
Speaking of the European Union, to explain it graphically, there is the Premier League, like the first league, the second league, and the third league, local league.
Premier League su oni koji su članovi Evropske unije.
The Premier League would be the members of the European Union.
Druga liga su oni koji su kandidati da budu članovi.
The second league would be the aspirant countries that would like to become members.
A treća liga su oni koji su daleko od toga.
And the third league would be those countries that are very, very far.
Mi smo trenutno u druga liga.
We are currently playing in the second league.
I nama nisu ista prava kao ovima u prvoj ligi.
And we do not have the same rights as those in the Premier League.
Znači, Evropska unija nije organizacija koja okuplja sve zemlje.
So the European Union is not the organization that actually gathers all the countries.
Tako da to je jedan ograničavajući faktor.
And this is certainly a limiting factor.
Ali dobro. Mi smo, da vam kažem, Evropska unija je pitanje ko zna šta će od međunarodnih organizacija opstati za 50 godina.
So it's very difficult to say at this point in 50 years time what organization will still be here or not.
A Srbija mora da opstane.
But on the other hand, Serbia has to be here.
I mi moramo voditi računa o našim interesima.
And we certainly have to take into account, take care of our own interests.
I now request Dr. Saraswat to propose a vote of thanks. I'm sorry, there are many more questions, but the minister has to go and call on the vice president.
On behalf of the council, I thank His Excellency Mr. Ivica Dacic for such an insightful lecture. I would also thank DG ICWA for chairing the session and our wonderful audience for their valuable participation. I would request everyone to join us in the foyer for high tea. Thank you.
Ja bih samo pozvao sve evropske i svetske lidere da više treniraju, da vežbaju jogu.
I would just call upon, in the end, let me call upon the European and global leaders to practice yoga more.